Nothing is what it seems has asked. Why do some dynos reach super high, like 80 horsepower or more, higher than other dynos out there? This is a great question, and to be perfectly honest, I can't give you a solid answer here. I've been in the tuning industry now for getting on towards 20 years. I've tuned on a wide variety of dynos. I've personally owned both a Dynopack hub dyno and now more recently our mainline rolling road dyno, and it is depressing how much lower our mainline rolling road dyno reads compared to our hub dyno. Now, some of that is understandable. With a hub dyno, we've got no tire contact patch where we can potentially be a source of power or drivetrain loss. Instead, we're directly linked straight to the hub. So naturally, a hub dyno is always going to tend to read higher. But even if we're talking about different brands of rolling road dyno, I know, for example, a Dynojet rolling road dyno will tend to read about 15 to 18% higher than our mainline dyno. The important thing to understand here, in my opinion, it honestly just doesn't matter. I know there are a lot of people out there that are just chasing a number for internet glory, but if that's your driving factor there, you're probably in it for the wrong reasons. What I'm meaning here is that really it doesn't matter if the dyno is reading horsepower, kilowatts, or megaponies. We're just using this as a tuning tool to help us with our tuning. So rather than the peak number, what I'm more interested in is the before and after. So did we pick up 40 horsepower or 100 horsepower from our starting point? That's really what we should be judging our performance on. Of course though, it is always beneficial to have at least some idea of what a baseline value should be for the certain car that we're tuning, so that we know if we're at least in the ballpark of where we should be for those given modifications. So this gets really tricky for those people out there who are taking their car to multiple tuners. I always recommend that you stick to one tuner who's using the same dyno. That way all of your results are going to be repeatable, and you're going to know from one dyno session to another whether you're going forwards, backwards, or sideways.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.